starting your journey to financial freedom.
Now.
You're listening to the New Investor Podcast.
This is the Young Investor for the New Investor Podcast, and it is day 103 on our journey towards financial freedom. The G20 summit last weekend did have its effect on the markets on Monday at open, a most positive one. A few episodes down, I did mention that we can undoubtedly expect the relations between US and China to ease up a little during that summit and the talks towards a trade agreement to resume. Now, this is all temporary, of course, as the truce will not fix the actual problems at hand. Another headline will affect this anyway very soon. Just expect it and factor it in your investment strategy. We'll get back to this a little bit later in the podcast. President Trump also stepped in North Korea, which shows how tensions can be managed generally through diplomacy rather than force. And usually diplomacy is good for the markets. And this is where we stand at the moment. And this buys us a little bit more time. Allow me to clarify, in the last few days, we have seen the markets recovering and even the S&P 500 to again reach an all-time high on Monday, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average as well. These indexes tell you the temperature on the markets. Quite good following the G20. If you deep dive a little bit in your research, other indicators are showing negative signs, however, pointing towards a possible recession. But let's keep this simple. All of this does not matter to me at all. There will be highs, there will be lows throughout our journey on the markets. I will step back when the markets are good and step in full force when the markets are in turmoil. So it does not matter. It is all a win-win situation anyway. So what I have also learned since is that once you have established your own financial structure and system around yourself that supports you towards freeing capital for investment, and I mean here regardless of the amount or what you're able to commit, as the important is to save. Once this is established, the routine of creating wealth will establish itself around yourself as well. So here is a little formula I find to be the simplest way of building wealth. That's the system you will simply need to consider on your investment approach. So let's just say that right now the markets are strong, healthy, and doing well, which equals to the stocks are expensive, which equals to I keep my saved cash until the markets start to correct or in crisis again, as they always do, equals to I buy stocks again of dividend paying companies I understand and love at the price I have determined to be appropriate through my research, which equals to I make a buy and hold it for 10 to 15 years. So what I look at currently is that my gain so far this year stand at 19% ahead today. The only thing that could happen that would wipe out all my gains and allow me to buy more stocks is an actual financial crisis happening this year. 19% loss is substantial and can be considered as a crisis. I am still waiting for this Apple earnings call, however, at the end of July, but I doubt that I will have a major buy opportunity given the recent news, which are highly favorable to Apple in the short to medium term. So my next aim, now that this is past and Apple is slowly getting away from my mind, my next aim is a repeat of 2018 in quarter four this year. This time I will be cash ready, as I have no other plans but Apple this year, apart as well from my current research on the real estate investment trusts I mentioned in the previous episode. So next question will be what to do with the parked cash until then, and where to have it wait while still generating some interest. So I'm looking into this, or maybe you can share your thoughts or recommendations on what you're currently doing on your side with your parked cash. Get in touch with me at contact@newinvestorpodcast.com. By the way, I would like to say thank you to the Stereo Stickman team. It's an online magazine, for their great coverage of the New Investor Podcast. I am glad you found tremendous potential in the podcast in our community. I placed the link in the description, that will take you to the article so that you can have a look if you're interested. I wish you all a plenty of success on this week ahead. Thank you for listening to the podcast, and I really hope that it brings you some additional support on your own journey towards financial freedom. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to never miss an episode, and looking forward to your DM and follow on Instagram at New Investor Podcast. In the meantime, stay invested, be patient, and keep playing the long-term game.
The podcast you just heard was made using Anchor. Ever thought about making your own podcast? Anchor makes it really easy for anyone to get started. It's a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing podcasts. Best of all, it's 100% free. Sign up now at anchor.fm/new. That's anchor.fm/new to get started.